All right, what's up, guys? So we got the motor here on the engine stand. I know you guys didn't get to see a video of me putting it in or pulling it out of the car, but what I'm gonna do right now is just go ahead and take off the headers and like literally everything, try and get everything off. You guys didn't get to see the video of me taking the motor out of the car because I was just like rushing and trying to do everything like hella fast because it was getting dark and I only have one more day left of my day off. But yeah, here it is, and we'll go ahead and start that. Look at Casey sitting right there, all pregnant and stuff. But yeah, I got the intake manifold, injectors, and fill rail. I got the flywheel right there. My intake, quarter intake, the harness, everything. The torque converter's down there. But let me go ahead and do this, and then I'll get back to you guys. I'll try and set the camera up somewhere so we could go ahead and just do like a time lapse. I did notice all this oil. Let me get another light. I did notice all this oil by the timing cover and stuff. So hopefully I didn't break a timing chain or something, because that would be really bad. But yeah, it goes all the way up here too. But I'm gonna go ahead and start taking off the headers and stuff. I already started with that bolt and like a couple more. But yeah, let me set you guys up somewhere. Alright guys, so as you saw, I got the headers out. I'm gonna be getting new headers, studs, and nuts or bolts, whatever you want to call it, and I'll also be getting long tube headers. I won't be using the stock headers anymore because I can't with the build I'm going with. But yeah, let's go ahead and I'll take off the front serpentine belt and the AC belt and everything, and then I'll go ahead and take off the pulleys, this pulley, all the tensioners, and the alternator. I'll go ahead and do that now. Alright guys, so I got all the pulleys out. I got the tensioner taken off from here, the pulley up here. This one, the water pump's about to come out. I even got the alternator out. Right now, I'm gonna go ahead and use this three-piece job puller. There's different sizes in here. Hopefully it works. And I'm gonna go ahead and take off the crankshaft pulley. So yeah, let's do it. Alright guys, so as you saw in the clip, it broke the smaller one. I went ahead and put a little bit bigger one on there, and hopefully that one doesn't break, because I'm gonna be pissed. But we'll go ahead and try it out. God, it just broke the other one too.
Stop breaking shit.
Fuck. All right, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and take off this small little thing right here. the heater core hose or whatever. And then I'm gonna take off these. Then I'm gonna go ahead and take off the coil packs, spark plugs, valve covers, and stuff. And then we'll take a look. I'll probably flip it over, or I don't know, I'm not sure yet. But yeah, I'll probably take off the valve covers and we could look at the cams and stuff. Alright, so this is the passenger side. There's some normal wear on the camshafts, if you guys can see. Nothing honestly looks broken in here. Everything looks the way it should be. The chains are pretty tight. All looks good in there. But yeah, let's go take off the other side and we'll see how that side looks. Alright guys, so I got the valve cover off on the driver's side and it has normal wear on the camshafts also. I'm probably gonna pull the spark plugs next because they're still in there, if you guys could see. And I'm gonna go ahead and see how those look. Next video we'll go ahead and show you guys when I take off this and I'll pull the heads off the motor. But let me go ahead and take off the spark plugs. Take out, I meant. Alright guys, so here are the spark plugs. Let me get a light real quick, hold up. They all have like the same amount of wear. So I don't know what that means, honestly, so far. They all look like they have the same amount of like wear on them and stuff, so not too worried about that. I don't really care, honestly. Motor's already blown. And I don't even know what's fucking broken in here. So we'll go ahead and take the crankshaft pulley out tomorrow. Then I'll pull the timing cover off. We'll take the timing chains off. And we'll pull the heads. And then I'll drop the oil pan tomorrow and you guys will see that in the next video. But yeah, I'm basically done today. I can't do anything else because I can't get this off. And in order to get the timing cover off, you have to pull this off. And I don't know what time it is. I'm not sure if AutoZone is open. Baby, what time is it?
10.
What time is it? Casey keeps saying it's bedtime. Look at her, guys. She got her blanket. Look at her stomach. Getting pretty big.
Oh, thanks.
But yeah, I got everything laid out here. With the driver's side, passenger side. I'm gonna go ahead and clear all these tools and stuff off the table so I could lay the valve covers off on each side. And then I'm gonna go ahead and put the heads on there too once I pull them, and probably all the pistons and everything. I got everything else down here, like the headers are right there and the alternator, all other bits and pieces that aren't too like fragile, like the fucking heads and everything else. But yeah, stay tuned for the next video. Here's the motor. And we'll get back to you guys when we pull the heads.